question is why. Why should the blues be so at home here? Well, America provided the atmosphere. America provided the atmosphere for blues, and blues was born. Blues was born on the American wilderness. Blues was born on the beaches where the slave ship was docked. Born on the slave man's auction block. The blues was born and carried on the howling wind. Blues grew up slave. Blues grew up as poverty. The blues grew up in Nat Turner visions. The blues grew up in Harriet Tubman courage. The blues grew up in small town deprivation. The blues grew up in big city isolation. The blues grew up in the nightmares of the white man. The blues grew up in the blues singing of Bessie and Billy and Ma. The blues grew up in Saxo's horn, on Duke's piano, in Langston's poetry, on ropes and baritone. The point is that the blues is grown. Blues is grown now, full grown, and you can trace the evolution of the blues on a parallel line with the evolution of this country. From blues rock to acid rock, from 13 states to Watergate, the blues is grown, but not at home. Blues is grown, but the country has not. The blues remembers everything the country forgot. It's a bicentennial year, and the blues is celebrating a birthday. It's a bicentennial blues. Bicentennial edition. The blues can quite amuse you, but make no mistake, it's a bicentennial year. A year of hysterical importance. A year of historical importance. Ripped off like donated moments from the past. 200 years ago this evening. 200 years ago last evening. And what about now? The blues is not. The blues has grown up and the country has not. The country has been ripped off. Ripped off like the Indians. Ripped off like jazz. Ripped off like nature. Ripped off like Christmas. Manhandled by media overkill. Goosed by aspiring vice presidents. Violated by commercial corporations. A bicentennial year. The year the symbol transformed into the BUY centennial. Buy a car, buy a flag, buy a map. So the public in mass has been bludgeoned into bicentennial submission or bicentennial suspicion.
Hey!
I fall into the blues. And America has got the blues. It's got the blues because of partial unification or partial accomplishment over partial periods of time. Halfway justice, halfway liberty, halfway equality. It's a half-ass year. We would be silly in all our knowledge and all our self-righteous knowledge when we sit back and laugh and mock the things that happen in our lives. To accept anything less than the truth about this bicentennial year. And the truth relates to 200 years of people and ideas getting by. We got by George Washington. The ideas of justice, liberty, and equality got cold by George Washington. Slave owner general. Ironic that the father of this country should be a slave owner. The father of this country, a slave owner, having got by him, it made it easy to get by his henchmen, the creators of this liberty, who slept in the bed with the captains of slave ships, fought alongside black freedmen in the Union Army, and left America a legacy of hypocrisy. It's a blue team. Got by Gerald Ford, oatmeal man. Has declared himself at odds. The people on welfare, people who get food stamps, daycare children, the elderly, the poor, women, and people who might vote for Ronald Reagan. Ronald Reagan, the guy by him, Hollywood. Acted like an actor, acted like a liberal, acted like General Franco when he acted like governor of California, now he acts like somebody who's going to be got by Jimmy Carter. Skip. Got by Jimmy Carter and got by him and his friend the Clinton. The creators of Southern Pride, Simple Talk. A blues trio. America got the blues. They got by Henry Kissinger, the international godfather of peace. A piece of Vietnam, a piece of Laos, a piece of Angola, a piece of Cuba. A blues quartet. point is that it may get by you for another 10 years, for another 8 years. You stuck.